Hey everyone, good morning. Welcome to the channel Learn Data Science with Pranjal. In this knowledge video, I will talk about Gini score. Gini score, which is used along with your entropy and decision tree. I will take one example wherein I will calculate the Gini score and then I will try to build and plot the decision tree using the Gini score and which will help us to verify our calculations. So let's see a small theory of Gini score and then we'll take one example. I have already created one slider on Gini score. So Gini index is also known as your Gini impurity index. Basically, Gini index was previously used to measure the income inequality, and now it is also being used in decision trees to build the decision trees. Gini index is range bound between your 0 to 1, and if the value of Gini index is high, it indicates that there is a large income inequality in the society. So when the Gini score is less, that conveys the more meaning to us, or when the Gini score is less, the first split should be taking place at your value where your Gini score is less. So we'll take one example where I'll try to find the Gini score. So Gini index is also used in decision tree like entropy. They can be used as a criteria to create the nodes as well. And the formula which I would be using is 1 minus summation I equal to 1 j pi square. So I would be talking on this formula. This formula would be much clearer once I take an example. But remember one thing, that P over here indicates your probability. Best case scenario is when your Gini score is 0, and the worst case scenario is that when your Gini score is 1. And where the score would be the least, I would be making my first split in my decision tree. So let's take one example. So I'm taking one example where I have four columns, that is your credit history, education, property area and loan status. So in this example, we can take our loan status as our target variable. So either you have Y or you have N in your loan status. Credit history, either you have your 1 or 0. So 1 means your credit history was good, 0 means your credit history was bad. So I've taken this data set purposefully because this data set has been used in my previous videos also, so that people can easily connect to it. And then education is your graduate or non-graduate. Property area, either you have urban or rural. So basically I have three variables or three X variables and one target variable, like we always have in any data frame when we are supposed to build a model. So we have few X variables and one target variable. And now what I will do is I will calculate the Gini score for each of them. So I'll calculate a Gini score with credit history and loan status, education and loan status, property area and loan status. And then I will try to build a tree. I'll try to build a tree based upon my Gini score. So let's do one thing. Let's take our property area and loan status and try to calculate our Gini score. So I'm taking property area and loan status. So let's say this is, if I consider this as one scenario. So I take property area. So I'm writing property area as your PA. So if property area is equal to urban, and if this condition is true, let's say, then I go on my left side, and if the condition is false, then I go on my right side. So if I go on my left side, what will happen? So how many property areas do I have? So if I see this table, I can see there that property area urban appears for your 6 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So urban appears 6 times, and when urban appears 6 times, so how many urbans records are there for which the loan status is Y? So I can see there are 4 Ys and 2 N. And if I move on the left side, sorry, if I move on the right side, when the property area is not equal to urban, when it's not equal to urban, so basically it's the ruler. So how many records do I have for the ruler side? I have 4 records, because totally there are 10 records. And out of these 4 records ruler, there are 1 Y and 3 N. So 1 Y here implies that for this loan was approved, and 3 N implies that your loan was not approved. And now let's apply this formula. 1 minus summation pi square I is equal to 1 to j. So if this formula is applied on your left side and I apply it on your 4y and 2n, then this formula would be written as 1 minus 4/6 whole square, because there are four records for which the loan was approved. So 4, and total records were 4 plus 2, 6. 4 plus 6 whole square plus 2/6 whole square. Right. So this is your Gini score on your of your left side. Similarly, Gini score of your right side would be something like this. I'll say 1 minus 1/4 whole square plus 3/4 whole square. So I've already calculated this value, and the final value comes out to be 4/9. And here the final value comes out to be 3/8. Final value comes out to be 3/8. Now what I'll do is, now I will take their weighted score. So 4/9 from your left side, 3/8 from your right side. So the weighted score would be, if I take the weighted score, then I will say 6/10 into 4/9. So this 6 is coming from over here. So total records on your left side, 6/10 into 4/9 plus 4/10 into 3/8. 4/10 into 3/8, and this 4/10 is coming from your this side. And then we can calculate the final value. So I've already done this calculation, and the value comes out to be 0.41. So remember this thing, that 0.41 is the value when you have done the calculation for your property area. So when you have taken the property area as a variable, then your Gini score is 0.41. Let's quickly take it for the other. So I've already drawn the diagram for the education. So now what I'm doing is I'm taking education and loan status. So if education equal to graduate, then, and if it's true, then I'm moving on your left side. So this is for true and this is for false. So if it's true, then how my data is split? So basically there are 5 records for graduate, and we can count them also. So the top 5 records are for graduate, and out of these top 5, for how many of them my loan was approved? Loan was approved for 3 people, right? And it was not approved for 2 people. So that is why I am saying 3y and 2n. And if your education is not graduate, so basically the person is non-graduate. So in non-graduate, again you have the 5 records, and out of those 5 records there are 3n and 2y's. So this is how your split is. Now let's calculate the Gini score. So Gini score on your of your left side would be like this. So 1 minus 3/5. Why 3/5? Why 5? Because I am having 5 records on the left side, and this 3 is basically mapped to your this 3. Okay. And this 2 is mapped to your this 2. And similarly, Gini on the right side. So I've already calculated the value, and the value comes out to be how much? I think the value comes out to be your 12/25. And here also it comes out to be 12/25. Now if I take the weighted score, then it would be 12/25 plus 5/10 into 12/25, and this value comes out to be 0.48. The value comes out to be 0.48. So similarly, let's calculate the Gini score with respect to credit history. So I've already drawn a basic diagram. So if credit history is 1, and if it's true, then I'm moving on my left side, and if it's false, then I'm moving on my right side. So when it's true, how many records do I have? So basically, when your credit history is equal to 1, you can see that there are 5 records. And when credit history is not equal to 1, or basically when credit history equal to 0, again you have 5 records. In credit history equal to 1, can you see that we have all the y's? So this 1 and y, this 1 and y, and again these three are 1's, and you have y's over here. So basically 5y and 0n, and similarly for false you have 0y and 5n. And now let's apply that formula. So I'll say 1 minus 5/5 whole square plus 0 by 5 whole square. So this would be the Gini score on my left side. So this would basically be equivalent to 0. And similarly, if I calculate the Gini score on the right side, this would be something equal to 1 minus 0 by 5 whole square plus 5 by 5 whole square, and this would again be 0. So finally, your Gini score for credit history would be equivalent to 0. So let's write down the Gini score for all the three variables. Gini score for your education is 0.48. Gini score for your property area is equal to 0.41. So if I am building a decision tree using these three variables, so your root node should be your credit history. Root node should be your credit history, because this is where your Gini score is least. And then your second node should be your property area. This should be your second node, and this should be your third node, and this should be your first node. Because when the Gini score is low, that is where your node formation takes place first. Let's quickly build our decision tree and see it. So this is where I try to build my decision tree. So I have already written the code for it. So I am creating four lists. One is your, the CH stands for your credit history, education. This PA stands for your property area, and loan status stands for your this thing. So if I run this thing, so if you see that this data exactly resembles the data which we have taken. So the loan status, property area, education, credit history, everything is same. Now what I am doing is I am converting these things into numbers, because otherwise I cannot get a decision tree, it will give an error. So for graduates I am marking 1, for non-graduates I am marking 0. If it's urban, I am marking as 1, and if it's rural, I am marking as 0. For loan status Y, I am marking as 1, and for N, I am marking as 0. So when I was creating this list, basically this 10101 credit history, and G stands for graduate, NG stands for your non-graduate. In property area, U stands for your urban, and R stands for your rural. And in loan status, Y stands for your Y, that loan is approved, and N stands for it's not approved. So now I'm converted into category. Then what I'm doing is I'm building my decision tree, and the criteria over here is your Gini score. Okay. So let's try to build a tree. So how I'm building a tree, I'm saying 0, 1, 2. So 0, 1, 2 indicates your credit history, education, and property area. And I know that these three are my X variables. And loan status is my target variable. So the way I'm passing my loan status is my saying -1. So it will select the last column or the first column from the right hand side. And the feature names I'm passing is 0, 1, 2. And this feature names variable, I'm using it over here. Okay. And when I build the tree, I get the tree something like this. And I can see that it is using CH, or that is your credit history, to be the most significant variable. So if it's true, then you go on your left side. And if it's false, you go on your right side. And when credit history is equal to 1, all the loans are approved. When credit history is equal to 0, all the loans are rejected. So there is no need to further break down your tree. Your tree stops over here. So remember, we have calculated the Gini score for our credit history, for property area, and for education. And the score was least for credit history. And we can see that in tree, when the score is least, that variable or that feature is being given the most importance, or you can say that that variable is taken as your root node. Let's do one thing. Let's not include our credit history and try to build it using another two variables and see what happens. So what I'll do is I will remove this 0 from here, because 0 represents my credit history column. So I'll not use my credit history column. I will use my 1 and 2, which will indicate my So 1 and 2 indicates my education and property area respectively. And since I am removing from there, let's remove it from here as well. Okay. So I remove from here and then I build it. And now what we can see? We can see that it has given, it has taken property area, this PA, as your root node. And if it's true, then it's checking your education and then so on. Okay. And if we look and if we check our calculation, then we have seen that the Gini score of property area was less compared to the Gini score of education, right? So this is how we can confirm it, that if your Gini score is less, it would be taken as your more important feature, or it would be given preference or the priority before the another feature. This is how I use my Gini score. Okay. So this brings us to the end of this knowledge video. This was a short knowledge video, but I hope you have enjoyed the video and it has given you the clear understanding about the. So if you have enjoyed the video, please go ahead and click on the like button. Thank you everyone for watching the video. Hope to see you soon in my next video. Till that time, happy learning.